Hello, my name is Tom Alwyn, and welcome to another video in the Invasive Species series. Today we'll be talking about how invasive species spread, and I'll be giving you some information on what you can do to ensure that you are not spreading invasive species. Invasive species impact every resident in Michigan to some degree, and it is important for everyone who uses or appreciates Michigan's great outdoors to do their part to reduce the spread of invasive species. By now, you understand the destruction invasive species can cause when introduced into an environment. Let's explore in more detail how they are introduced into new environments. Take a look here. This is the spread of zebra mussels from 1986 through 2014. The methods species use to move and spread are referred to as pathways. The large geographic jumps zebra mussels made across the nation are likely due to hitchhiking on boats. Invasive species can spread using the same methods that native species use. They use immigration, they can use wind dispersal, or they can attach to other animals, known as hitchhiking. Aquatic species use hydrologic connections to move around, including flowing rivers, streams, and more. But most importantly, people move invasive species around, whether they mean to or not. Invasive species can be spread by misplaced good intention too. Examples include a neighbor sharing a shrub that grew well in their yard, or someone releasing live pets or bait into the environment, thinking that it's the humane thing to do. These good intentions could actually be introducing an invasive species. This can be especially harmful if the animal or plant has a competitive advantage over native species. This includes animals used in classroom studies, pets and garden plants, and live fishing bait. An excellent example of what can happen comes out of Wisconsin. In 2009, red swamp crayfish were discovered in two ponds near Milwaukee. It took 5 years and hundreds of thousands of dollars to eradicate them. While the source of the crayfish is unknown, it's believed that they either escaped or were released. Many of the pathways for invasive species to spread are directly connected to human activities. If you love camping or spending time by a bonfire, it's important that you use firewood from a local source. Here is a photo from PJ Hoffmaster State Park on the Lake Michigan shoreline after approximately 200 oak trees had to be cut down due to oak wilt, an invasive tree disease. The disease likely came to the park on firewood brought in from another region by campers. When you leave a site, take a moment to inspect all of your gear, clothing, and pets. Look for seeds, dirt, and mud, any plant material, standing water, and live animals. If you find anything, clean it off before you leave the site. It could be an invasive species. In this video, we've learned that invasive species use numerous pathways to get to new environments, and that preventing those introductions is essential. To learn more about invasive species, please visit michigan.gov/invasive-species. The site provides information on invasive species specific to Michigan. There you can also learn about laws, permitting, grants, volunteer opportunities, and more. So remember, even if an invasive species is widespread, it doesn't mean that it's everywhere. So please take care to ensure that you're not moving invasive species. Thanks for watching.